Hi! In this video, I'm going to show you how you can blend between two sets of textures, and I use Vertex Painting for that, directly inside the engine. And instead of the default linear interpolation that vertex color gives us between the vertices, I use a method that is called HeightLerp, like in hive-based linear interpolation. And this method makes use of a hive map, a texture that defines the variation of the blending. So the moss first covers the creases, and it requires a very big value of the blending mask to appear on the topmost bricks. As I use only the red channel for the blending of the textures, I can still utilize the green and blue channels. So here, for example, I'm using the green channel to change the color of the bricks, between light bricks and darker bricks. The Vertex Painting panel is located on the left toolbar or under the shortcut Shift 2. Then you can select the channels to paint on, and as you can see here, you can preview the channel directly. By pressing this bucket, you can erase the or fill the entire channel. And as you can see, the mesh is quite low poly. So definitely the default blending between the vertices is not enough. It's not detailed enough. It's way, way too smooth. So that's why we need this alternative method for blending, this HeightLerp. Using HeightLerp makes the blending definitely more interesting. It looks like the moss reacts to the height of the bricks, and from only so many vertices, we can get a very detailed transition. The great advantage of vertex painting technique is that you can paint separately on each instance. So it's especially useful for environments where you have dozens of identical modules. If you painted it on a mask and then use it as a texture, the pattern will repeat on every instance of the mesh. While here, you can paint separately on each mesh, so it's a great way to add some variation to environments in just minutes. Okay, so first, let us create this basic, ugly vertex blending material, and later we will move on to HeightLerp. So utilizing the vertex color in the shader is extremely easy. It just requires us to create a vertex color node. From that, we have access to each channel separately. Now I will create texture samplers for every texture needed. As you can see, we have only 16 texture samplers per material to our disposal. It may sound like much, but it's not, believe me. It's a very low number, because imagine if you have to blend between three kinds of materials, each with their own base color, roughness, ambient occlusion. So what I did, and what is typically done to save memory, is to pack three channels, for example roughness, ambient occlusion, and metalness, into a single texture. So the red channel contains metalness in my example, the green channel contains occlusion, and the blue channel contains roughness. It has to be done in an external texture editor or 2D software. Okay, the final texture looks strange, but each channel is more meaningful. We have no metallic here, this is the ambient occlusion, and this is the roughness. The compression settings have to be set to masks. So the basic method of blending is using the LERP node, which is linear interpolation. You just specify the first texture or the first color, then the second texture, and the value that blends between them. Yeah, so putting the vertex color's red channel to the linear interpolation alpha gives us the desired result. So if the value is closer to 1, then it is more likely to use the second texture. while the value of 0 will give us the first texture. Value of half blends between the two textures, they are both equally important. So this is how our basic vertex color blending works. Currently we are using only the base color. We can repeat this for metal occlusion and roughness. The same goes obviously for the normal map. And again, we connect vertex color to the alpha of linear interpolation. And after the blending, we separate our masks into three channels. So as you remember, red goes into metallic, greens go into ambient occlusion, and blue is roughness. Let's attach the normal map. Unfortunately, with many textures to blend, it gets quite messy. Okay. Let's see how it works. All the channels are nicely blended. So now, let us replace Lerp with HeightLerp. It's a single node that works exactly the same. The alpha of Lerp is now called transition phase. It's basically the same parameter, just a different name. Okay. But now, as you can see, we have to specify a hive texture. What HeightLerp does is varying the transition with a given texture. The hive map here is just a name. It can be any pattern you like. The brightest parts of the hive map will be the first to use the second input, while the black parts need a very strong value to consider the second input. Additionally, we can specify a contrast. And to set the contrast, I have to create a parameter. The same values are between 0 and 8. I like the default of 0.33, sometimes 0.5, but it depends, of course. Now let us find our hive map. The hive map in my example looks like that. It's really the hive of the bricks, generated in bitmap to material from a photo. And let's connect it again to base color. Fine, as you can see, the blending type has changed. But still, it's not what we need. Because in our example, we wanted the moss to cover the cracks first, while here the moss covers the bricks first. So we will need to invert this hive map. So if you have values that go from 0 to 1, like in this grayscale textures example, then inversion is just 1 minus the value. So 0.1 becomes 0.9, and 0.8 becomes 0.2. 1 minus value is just the inversion. Let us test how it works. And it's exactly what we need. The creases are covered first, and the highest bricks are covered last. Now, we may want to add some possibility for the user to either use this inversion or not. So I create a scalar parameter, and if the parameter is 0, then I will use the standard map, and if it's 1, then I will use the inverted map. So we can just round the value, because unfortunately Unreal Engine doesn't have an integer kind of parameter. Or I just forgot about something. But still we can round it to either 0 or 1. And use, guess what? Linear interpolation for that. I will attach this parameter to the alpha, and that's it. It's not necessary, of course. But now we have some control over this. if we, for example, change a height map to a different texture. You can also do exactly the same with a static switch, but the disadvantage of using static switches is that you get two separate copies of the shader, because static switch generates two versions of the shader for each switch. So in simple cases like here, it's more convenient to use just a simple scalar parameter as a toggle of some feature. So now I replace all the lerps with HeightLerps. We are using only the red channel now, so we still have two spare channels to use. So exactly like in the first example I shown on the video, we will change the base color of the bricks using the green channel of vertex color. I will blend between the default texture of the bricks and the version multiplied by some darker color. Let's use some yellow. Not too saturated. And again I will use HeightLerp for that, but this time it will be the non-inverted version of the height map, the default version, because I want the highest bricks to get dirty early. Yeah, now I attach the green channel as the transition phase. So this is how it looks like, a simple operation. Let's select the green channel in the Vertex Painting menu. And while it does what we need, maybe I shouldn't have used the common contrast. It will be better to specify a separate contrast value for that. Some smooth value. Yeah, much better. And because the color is a parameter, we can change it dynamically in any time, and this thing alone is a huge advantage over painting all this dirt and moss in some external software. Things are much, much easier to adjust when done in the shaders. The only cost of doing it in the shaders is obviously the amount of processing it requires on the GPU, but HeightLerp is not so expensive operation. And the basic lerp is one of the cheapest operations you can use in the shader. So don't worry about mixing things with lerp, as long as it allows you to achieve the effect you want. While we spend some processing power here, we gain huge benefits when it comes to memory storage requirements. And we are done. In case you have any questions, please let me know in the comments, and see you next time!